Hey, hi, this looks like a wonderful property. So, do you stay here or are you visiting here?
No, I stay in this building, Lodha.
You stay here?
Yeah, I stay here.
Which tower?
Parkside.
So, where do you stay here?
Lodha.
Which tower do you stay in?
I stay in KAGR. I just shifted to KAGR.
And what's the rent you are paying here?
I am paying close to 1.5 lakh.
You stay in this apartment itself?
Yeah, I stay here in Marquis.
Got it. And you've owned the apartment or you've rented it?
Yeah, it's my apartment.
I see your ISB t-shirt as well. Can you tell me how much did you spend at ISB?
The tuition is about 35 to 40 lakhs, or at least it was back when I used to study there. The ballpark should be the same right now.
And which year did you study there?
Batch of 2021.
What do you do for a living?
So I lead marketing and branding for the strategic unit of Bloom Ventures. I help their portfolio companies create their own brands and kind of go to market and help brand the founders as well. So, yeah.
And what are you doing right now?
I just joined Anand Rathi Group in their family office, working in their investments and the hedging team as of right now.
How much did you spend on education? What exactly you did and what was the return on investment?
So I did my CA. And I'm pursuing CFA. I've cleared my level one. Approximately in CA, I guess it was 3.5-4 lakhs, including the classes and everything, and CA fees and everything. And in CFA, I think so per level, it takes around 1 lakh. So I'm giving my level two in May.
What's your educational background and how much you've spent on your education so far?
So I was in Christ University where I studied economics honors, and Christ University, the fee was not much. I can't remember the fee precisely, but I think the living expenses were around 40 to 50,000 a month. Post my college, I didn't start working at a company because of COVID, but my friends have been working in EY, Goldman Sachs, and they earn around 10 to 12 lakhs a month. So most of them got
12 lakhs a month?
Sorry, a year, my bad. 10 to 12 lakhs a year, and most of them got a promotion now, so you know they've been getting better salaries. I have no clue. We don't speak much about salaries. Yeah.
What have you done in your education?
So for me, at the onset, I have to say it's a passionate journey. We started with financial management, which I did it in 94-96, which at that time, prior to 2000, fashion was not considered to be the paying industry in terms of monetary level. And as you said, the ROIs were definitely not there. It was basically considered to be a home kind of a business. So post that, I got a scholarship with doing software engineering, which was the upcoming industry at that time. So like 2 years software engineering in UK. And after coming back, I was working with a leading designer, which prompted me to explore my creative energies. So NIFT was a journey which I think I'm passionately involved with fashion, textiles, and of course the business side of it, the merchandising side of it, for the last 2 decades.
What do you do for a living here?
So I'm a banker. I manage product and partnerships for a large private sector bank. And second part is I'm a very active investor and a trader in equities. So I invest a lot in companies which I really believe in. So that's another source of income for me.
How much did you spend on your education? What's your educational background?
So I'm an MBA from IIM Shillong. I was the gold medalist there. And I spent around, close to 15 lakhs. And my first job which I got was for an annual package of 18 lakhs. So I got my ROI covered in first year itself.
So what's the return on investment one can expect after getting into ISB? What was your first salary around?
My first salary covered more than 80% of my tuition that I spent at ISB. Most people will recover about 100% of their return on investment in a year or a year and a half.
And if you can help us understand your jump of salary pre-MBA to post-MBA, what would this ratio be?
For me, it was about 4x, but it could vary from 3x to 10x. I mean, I'm not sure of the official numbers, but for me, it was about 4x.
And what is something that ISB taught you which is helping you in your day-to-day life today?
I think problem solving, which transcends the business world, which transcends management, trying to be a problem solver in every facet of life, and having a broader horizon is something which I learned at ISB, amongst many other things.
How much did you spend on education and what was the return on investment? That'll be helpful.
So I just did a simple BMM, a mass media course, which was 16,000 rupees per year for 3 years. So that's roughly 45,000-50,000 rupees. My first internship was 5,000 rupees per month in the summer. So I realized that, oh, I can just offset my college cost with like 3 months of an internship. My first salary started off at 20,000, which was a pre-placement offer from one of the companies that I interned at, which was simply, you know, managing their social media, putting up captions and all of that. over time, I taught myself design, branding, upskilled, worked at Topper, which is an edtech app at that time. Did a lot of PR for them, branded the founder, and now this is where I am with Bloom, where I'm actually helping the founders create their own brand.
And what was your first salary? Because we also want to know the return on investment.
So my first job was as an article in PwC. So that was the stipend, which we used to get at 10,000 per month. But if you ask me post-qualification salary, it was around 12 plus variables.
See, what do you do for a living here?
I'm a lawyer. I'm training under a counsel of the Bombay High Court.
If you're a lawyer, can you help us understand what's the total cost which you've spent in your education and what one can expect after becoming a lawyer?
So I was admitted to Government Law College, which is unique in its way of fee structure. So it is subsidized. My fee for the entire 5-year course was 30,000 rupees. That's it to get the law degree. It's a BALLB degree. And after that, you can join either litigation or corporate. This is how the industry is broadly structured. So I'm in litigation. Litigation, the concept is you don't really earn money until you learn and get the expertise from your senior. Once you leave your senior and start your own practice, that's where you get to earn the real money.
So what's the importance of upskilling in your life? How did that benefit you and how much did you spend on upskilling?
I didn't actually spend a lot. It was a lot of free YouTube videos, some, really basic upgrad courses. I didn't really invest that way, but you don't have to spend a lot of money in marketing, especially. You don't need a fancy degree to really get ahead. It's all about how you can show your work.
How do you spend your time on upskilling and ensuring you're staying updated with the relevant skills in the industry?
So for all the lawyers, the only trick is to read as much as you can. We have softwares like SCC and Manupatra, where you read binding precedent judgments, and that's the skill we need to know. You need to analyze past judgments, and when to use which judgment is what is required. So the only trick is to read as much as you can.
Got it. That's a very brilliant piece of advice. Guys, even I am doing law, by the way, but I've dropped out from my second year. After listening to him, probably I'll reconsider my decision of doing law once again. How do you manage your own money, in the sense what proportion is invested in what kind of asset class?
I am more of an equity person, but I do believe that emergency does not knock before it strikes you. So if I have to say whatever I earn, right, 50% of that goes towards my savings and 50% of that goes towards my expenses, right? Roughly whatever 50% which I save, out of that 50% I allocate to hardcore equities. I allocate it to companies which are mid-caps, which are doing really well, and 30% in ETFs like Nifty Bs, Bank Bs, Gold Bs, and another 20% in liquid funds, so that whenever you need money right away, you have it.
So you've done CA and CFA. I'm pretty sure that you're very well with money management because you're already doing that role. So if you can help us understand, how do you manage your own money? That'll be helpful.
Close to 90-95% of my salary goes into stock market. Out of those 90-95%, 20-25% is in public equities. But rest all, I'm a great fan of derivatives. That's why you can tell me as a trader itself.
What sort of returns do you make on a monthly basis or annual basis?
So I'm trying to achieve 5% per monthly with my trading amount. And the stocks which I have invested, the 20-25% of my salary, that gives me close to around 12-13% return. But I pledge those shares and I use those money in trading. So the ROI is quite great as of right now.
And how do you manage your own money? You mentioned that you already work at a broking firm. So how do you divide your wealth into what kind of asset classes?
Oh, so I've divided my wealth. So I only invest in equities and derivatives because I think I'm at a younger age and I can take more risks. But I divide my portfolio 50% only into equity, long only equity. And 50% I invest in derivatives. I do a lot of option selling. You know, whenever I'm short on the market, I go towards the derivative sites. And futures, where I'm long on a few stocks. I don't want to mention them, but I use futures when I'm long on a few stocks for a short run.
What's the typical return you can expect on a monthly basis if you do all these things?
See, it depends. Currently, the market is in a bull run, so monthly returns are good from 5%, anywhere between 5% to 15%. But this is not a sustainable market right now. But let's say post the union elections, when the results are out and the market again slows down, I think a yearly return of 25 to 30% is what we target.
Someone wants to get into ISB. What is one piece of advice you would like to give it to them?
I think first is to understand and have a clarity of vision that where do you want to be in 2 years, 5 years, and 10 years, and a clarity of vision on why do you want to do an MBA. After that, it's just dedication and hard work.
What is one piece of advice which you would like to give to all the aspiring entrepreneurs who are watching this?
I would like to say one thing, which I have been telling my students also, that think of something out of the box and creative. That one idea is very important. I mean, even as a startup or anything else, everybody wants something which is new. So because, I mean, obviously, you know, because of international boundaries being eliminated, all thanks to metaverse and digital marketing being at the forefront today, I would like to say, please explore a lot of avenues. Do not take things which were already there, but be a thinker.
Any one piece of advice which you'd like to give to all our viewers?
Start investing as early as you can. It can be in mutual funds, SIP, anywhere. I'll say start investing in your own stocks, do some basic research, watch some great channels like Z Business. I follow Z Business. But start investing as early as you can. Open your own DMAT account as fast as you can. That's the only advice I can give as of right now.
So what is one piece of advice which you'd like to give to all our viewers who want to get into stock markets?
Really learn, then start earning. Don't jump into the river trying to figure out how deep is it. You really need some learning and mentorship to survive the initial few years, because beginner's luck don't work in this market.
And lastly, if someone who wants to get into stock markets and investing, what is that one piece of advice you would like to give to that person?
Try. I mean, I think there's a big learning curve, and the learning curve happens when you start in the market. I think when you lose money initially, that is the fee you pay to the markets for teaching you what is to be done and how is to be done. So,
got it. Perfect. Thank you so much for doing this.
Thank you so much, Kushal.
Thanks.